Oh yeah. Here we are. Welcome back to the McMahon Group, everyone, and welcome to Workout Wednesdays, brought to you by Functional Fitness. Hey, you know, did you sleep in through your alarm this morning, but you had every intention of getting up and exercising, and then you think, well, I'll do it after work today. And then you come home from work and you're like, I'm too tired, it's too hot, I just want to have a beer and just watch some TV. And all of a sudden you realize, 30 pounds later, you're in a rut. Well, I've got the owners of Functional Fitness joining me this morning, and they're gonna give us some stretching exercises, some things that we can do at work. Welcome, guys. We've got Jeremy Jones here and Luis Galindo. Ooh, how are you doing?
Having us here. We're doing really good.
Doing great. Oh. Appreciate you having us here again.
Oh my gosh. Well, we are thrilled to have you be a part of Workout Wednesdays and giving us all this advice and ways that we can help strengthen our core and, you know, and help us just feel better and get through the summer heat and get through the days.
Yeah,
so,
yeah, exactly.
You know, with some of these exercises we're about to learn here, I think you also have a giveaway that you are going to offer to our viewers. And Luis, do you want to tell us what they will receive?
Yeah, they're going to receive a session with one of our personal trainers at Functional Fitness. If you guys want to just call us and let us know, and you guys will receive that session.
And it's an $80 value, right?
$80 value, correct.
Okay, so AZTV viewers.
What?
I don't know, what should we do? Three?
I'd say caller number seven.
Okay, caller number
Lucky seven.
Lucky number seven. Call right now. You will receive a free training session courtesy of Luis and Jeremy from Functional Fitness. It's an $80 value. They're located over there in Gilbert. Mm-hmm. And come get fit with them. So, all right, let's talk about this summertime rut and trying to fit a workout in with your day.
Mm-hmm. Well, one of the biggest things to focus on is movement. So like you said, maybe you miss a workout in the morning, but there's always some way you can move. There's some way you can get the blood flowing, get your heart rate up, and get the body doing something that's not normally used to doing.
Yeah.
So for one, we got to get people up out of the chairs. So if you're at the office, at work, on the couch, at home, it's time to get up. Right now, while you're watching, let's get up.
Okay, come join us.
All
right.
We're going to go through four different dynamic stretches. So dynamic stretches being more using your entire body, getting that blood flowing again, and using your muscles to move versus just doing a static hold.
Got it.
Okay?
Yeah.
So this first one we're going to learn is the world's greatest stretch.
All righty.
So,
I'm ready.
Lisa, this might be a first for you.
Okay, where do you want me?
You and Luis both will kind of demo. He's a pro at this one,
So what we're going to do, we're going to start just in your normal stance, right?
Yeah.
We're going to do just like a lunch, we're going to do a really large lunch, really long lunch, right?
Okay.
We're going to reach forward.
When you have a 28 inseam, it's not that long, but go ahead.
And then we're going to get our hands and put them on the floor,
uh-huh.
Right? Make sure that knee doesn't go over the toes.
Okay.
Right? And then we're going to come back. We're going to try
stretch
to leave your hands on the floor and then stretch that hamstring. You feel that?
I'm feeling it right here. Is that where I'm supposed to
feel
it?
That's where you're supposed
there?
To feel it. And then we're going to stand up. Right?
Ooh. Uh-huh.
And we're going to do the same thing forward. So let's just step back so we don't get out of the camera. But then we're going to take the same step forward. Really long lunge.
Wow.
Right?
Yep.
Nice stretch in those hip flexors. And then going back and getting that hamstring there.
Now, should I try to extend this leg all the way back?
All the way back. If you
I
have
can.
The flexibility, she probably does have better flexibility than I do, then you want to lock that leg.
Oh,
right?
Lock it, okay.
And then go ahead and stand up again, nice and easy.
Do you find
that... Then you can just walk through your house or through your office and do that. You know?
Do you find that people favor one side versus the other? Like, for me, it was easier for me to do my right side versus my left.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah? Mm-hmm.
Yeah, the leading leg usually is going to be a little bit tighter from that hip flexor from the top of the lower back. So,
and how many times should I do these?
I will do about 20 times.
Okay.
So
you
can
a long
like
hallway.
You can do a long hallway, or you can just step forward and back like we just did.
Okay.
But it would be really good for those hip flexors. Those hip flexors are going to be really tight from us driving, being in the office, being
sitting
in the computer,
day.
Sitting all there. They're going to get short. So when they get short, they get tighter.
Mm-hmm. Right. Okay. Yeah. Got it. So the lunges. Got it.
So we got that. So we're getting some blood flowing there. So we kind of started touching on that. Next, we're going to go even a little deeper into the hip flexors specifically.
Ooh.
So we got the hammies. We got some quads, hip flexors. Now, this next one, this is called the wave. So all you sports fans out there, when you go to the games, you're doing the wave. Great way to remember this one. So all you're going to do, you're going to start off here. Step backwards.
Okay.
Squeeze that cheek of the leg you're stepping back with and really pull that knee back. Reach those arms high into the sky.
There you go.
And then come back up.
Yeah.
Alternate legs. Do the wave again.
Oh, wow.
Cheer on your favorite
team, right? Squeeze, yep.
There you go. Coming back and forth.
That feels great.
So same thing there. You're feeling that stretch. And the great thing about this is you're feeling that stretch all the way up across the waist there.
There and my shoulder blades as
well. Yeah, kind of feeling those lats stretching out as well. Yep.
Oh, that feels awesome.
So that's a great one, too. And again, waves, real easy to remember. Again, think sports. Yeah. Keeping those arms moving in there.
How many of these should we do?
Just like Luis said, about 20 of them. And really, it's what feels good for you. You know, when do your legs start feeling like they're loosening up a little bit? When do you feel like you don't have that same computer posture?
Yeah, okay? I mean, and just the energy that it gives you.
Yep.
Oh, awesome. Okay, got it.
All right.
The wave.
The wave. So now we're gonna get the we're gonna grab the PVC pipes here in the corner, do a little shoulder mobility. So Luis is gonna lead you through some shoulder work here.
So first one we're gonna do, we're gonna try to face each other here, right? Mm-hmm. And we're gonna lock our elbows. So anytime you're holding this PVC pipe, which by the way, I got it at your local hardware store, right? They're already cut out like that. You're gonna go up and as far as you feel comfortable and just try to keep those elbows locked, right? And you can do this with a broomstick as well.
Oh,
don't you feel, doesn't
gosh.
It feel great?
Just oh, yeah.
Those chest muscles,
opening,
get
yeah,
your
the
lats,
chest cavity.
Your mm-hmm. back muscles, yeah.
Gina, so I skipped that one.
So doing this, she's pretty good with her lingo, though.
Doing the same one, right?
Knows.
Yeah. I know, I just have to get back in shape after everything.
Now we're going to go wide stance, and we're going to go rock the boat. So we're going to go side.
This is rock the boat.
Side, yeah.
Oh, my gosh.
So we call this rock the boat.
Wow.
Get those hips, right? Get those lats.
Very
now, how do I know
done.
If I'm doing this correctly at home? Because part of me feels like I want to lean forward.
It's really simple. I mean, just like I said, that rule of thumb, keep those elbows locked, and you can lead from your middle back, or you can do it from your hips.
Hips or
right?
middle back,
so you can do just like that. And same thing, you want to do about 10 to 20 of them.
Okay, 10
You can
to 20.
Do this at your office, too, and you don't really need a PVC pipe. If you just do it, just go like this, you know, you can stand up. And you can lead by example with your coworkers, right?
Yeah.
They can maybe start a whole thing where you do it with all your coworkers.
No, and this is terrific. And what's one more that we can do here?
So another quick one here that we'll run through is just called a walkout. So another great one for the hamstrings as well as your upper body.
Yeah.
All you're going to do here, Lisa, you're going to start walking out here just like you're going in a push-up position. Come on with me now. Come on with me. And then from there, we're going to start pushing those heels down to the ground.
Oh, wow.
Keeping those legs straight.
Yep.
Feeling those calves and hamstrings stretching all the way out.
Oh, my gosh. And my lower back. My lower back's been so tight lately.
Everything stretching through there.
Got it.
That's the beauty of all of these. Like you were talking with Luis, you really can't go wrong here. It's a matter of moving your own body and getting that blood flowing throughout your body.
And strengthening the core.
You got it.
Because if this is strong, then everything will remain strong.
Everything else, you got it.
Oh,
right on.
Thanks, you guys.
Yeah.
Thanks for coming with us on the show here and everybody working out with us here at home. Great tips for the office, and we'll be right back after this.
Thanks again. Have a great week.
Terrific.